गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप ऑल आर यू गुड एंड डूइंग योर स्टडी वेल। लास्ट टाइम वी हैव बीन डन द क्वेश्चन अप टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5। नाउ टुडे हियर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर क्वेश्चन नंबर 6। इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 यू आर गिवन अ वायर ऑफ कॉपर हैविंग डायमीटर 0.5 mm एंड रेजिस्टिविटी 1.6 × 10⁻⁶ ओम सेंटीमीटर एंड इट्स रेजिस्टेंस इज 10 ओम। वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द लेंथ। हाउ मच लेंथ इज रिक्वायर फॉर दिस पर्पज और टू ऑब्टेन अ रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस मच ओम। एज वी नो आर इज इक्वल टू रो एल बाय ए, सो फ्रॉम हेयर एल मस्ट बी इक्वल टू आर इंटू ए बाय रो एंड हेयर ऑल दी फैक्टर्स आर गिवन। द वैल्यू ऑफ आर इज 10 ओम एंड रेजिस्टिविटी इज 1.6 × 10⁻⁶ ओम सेंटीमीटर इट इज, सो यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट इट इंटू ओम मीटर, सो इट विल बिकम 1.6 × 10⁻⁸ ओम मीटर। नाउ एरिया विल बी पाई आर स्क्वेयर एंड हेयर डायमीटर ऑफ द वायर इज गिवन दैट इज 0.5 mm एंड यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट इट इंटू रेडियस एंड इट विल बिकम 0.25 mm एंड यू कैन कन्वर्ट मिलीमीटर इंटू मीटर बाई मल्टीप्लाइंग बाई 10⁻³। And you can put all the values in your formula, that is L is equal to R A by rho. Here R 10, 1.6, rho is 1.6 × 10⁻⁸ and A is pi R square and pi is 3.14 and R is 0.25 mm and simplify and you will get the length of the wire is 122.7 meter. Now we have to determine in the second part of it its resistance whenever its diameter is doubled. As we know, whenever diameter of the wire is doubled, then its area become 4 times, as A is equal to pi r square, and if a diameter doubled, then radius also become double and the square of the when the square of the doubled factor become 4 times. So here A dash area must be equal to 4a, because if diameter double, then radius also get double, and if radius double, then area become 4 times. And we know R is equal to rho L by A, and if R dash is the new resistance and then it will become rho L by A dash, and the value of A dash is 4 times of the A. So our by putting here the value of A dash, it will become R dash must be equal to rho L by 4A, and this is 1/4 of the previous value. So resistance become 1/4 whenever its diameter is doubled. Now question number next, question number 7. In this question you have to plot a graph between V and I. Experiment we had done related to this numerical. Here V and I are given and you have to take I along y-axis and V along x-axis, and then by taking a suitable scale you can draw, suppose here 1, 2, 3, and 4, this is the current, and you can take voltage 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 and then 14. So you can take the voltage like this and can plot the graph between these two. So here firstly current is 0.5 and voltage is 1.6. So you can take a point like this, and in the next case current is 1 and voltage is 3.4 will be here, and then 2 and 6.7, 2 and 6.7, and then 3 and 10.2, and then 4 and 13.2, like this. And then you can join and you will obtain the graph like this. So in this question you have to plot a graph and then you have to determine the value of r from the graph, and r must be equal to delta v by delta I. Delta v is the difference of any two values of the voltage, and delta I is the difference of the corresponding values of the current. So now let's see the next question. So you can see here the graph is drawn and two values are taken. This is delta I and this is delta V, and then divide and you got the resistance. Now let's see the next question. Question number 8. This is very easy. When a 12 volt battery connected to a resistor of and draw a current of 2.5 milliampere, we have to calculate the value of resistance R. As we know, R is equal to V upon I from the Ohm's law, and here V is 12 volt and I is 2.5 milliohm, milliampere. So we have to convert it into ampere by multiplying 10 to power minus 3. So by simplifying, and we will get R must be equal to, that is 12 by taking 10 to power minus 3 above, it become positive, and this is 2.5. we can write it 25 by multiplying 0 the numerator, and we can cut 25 1 25, 25 4 100, and then 4, it will become 200, and 25 8 is 200, 4.8 into 10 to power 3, 10 to power 3 means kilo, so it will become 4.8 kilo ohm or 4800 ohm. You can write. Very easy question. Now the question number 9. In question number 9, here some resistors are given and these are connected in series, and you have to calculate the current across the resistor of a 12 ohm. As these resistors are connected in series, so current will remain same through each resistor. So first of all, we have to calculate net resistance in series. These 5 resistors connected in series, so net resistance will be R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4 plus R5, and by adding all these 3 resistors, we will get net resistance 13.4, and then I will be V upon R, and V is 9 volt here, and by dividing this factor you will get the net current through each resistor, and same current will be across the 12 ohm resistor. Now the question number 10. In question number 10, you have to calculate how many resistors of a 176 ohm each connected in parallel so that they draw a current of a 5 ampere. If we will assume n resistor of a 176 ohm connected in parallel, then their net resistance will be 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by Rn, and so on up to n times. So after adding these, it will become n by 176, and the value of R from here, 176 by n. As we know, according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, and V given to us 220 volt, I is 5 ampere, and we have been calculated the value of R, that is 176 by n, and after cross multiplying we will get the value of n, and n will be 5 into 176 by 220. So we can cut 5 for ja 20, 5 for ja 20, and then 44 for ja 176. Therefore 4 resistor of a 176 ohm each, whenever connected in parallel, they draw a current of a 5 ampere. So 4 resistors are required in parallel for this purpose. Now the question number 11. here three resistor are given each of value 6 ohm and we have to connect them in such a way our net resistance become 6 ohm and in second part it will become 2 ohm. So to obtain a resistance of a 6 ohm we have to connect two in parallel and then third one is in series with this combination because this is 6 and this is 6 and this is 6 their resultant become 1/6 1/6 1/6 + 1/6 which means 2/6 which means 2/6 means 1/3 and after reciprocal its value become 3 and this connected in series with 6 ohm so it will become 6 and 3 become 9 ohm so whenever two resistor in parallel connected with 6 ohm in series then it will become 9 ohm now in the second part we have to calculate 2 ohm so to obtain 2 ohm net resistance we have to connect all these three resistors in parallel to each other because in parallel net resistance become 1/6 + 1/6 + 1/6 and after that 3/6 and then 1/2 and reciprocal of 1/2 is 2 so a resistance of 2 ohm can be obtained by connecting them all the three resistor in parallel as you can see here and in first case 2 in parallel and 1 is in series so in this way you can do this question now the question number next that is question number 12 so let's see our question number 12 here several bulbs of a are used on 220 volt line and each of power is 10 watt and we have to calculate the maximum number of bulb that draw a current of 5 ampere suppose we have n bulbs and then their power p become 10 into n because the power of each bulb is 10 and for n bulb it become 10n as we know p is equal to v into i and here value of p is 10n and v is 220 and I is 5 ampere so 0 is cancelled by the 0 and n become 25 to 5 is 110 so 110 bulbs are required in parallel for this purpose or to obtain a current of 5 ampere from the 220 volt line now the question number 13 here two resistor coil A and B are given and each of them have a resistance of 24 ohm and we have to calculate the current in each case whenever these are connected separately and then in series and third one is in parallel so first of all we will do for separately as we know I is equal to V upon R here V is 220 and separately the resistance of each will be 24 and after dividing we will get the answer for the first part now whenever these are connected in series two resistor 24 ohm each connected with each other then the net resistance become 48 because in series R1 plus R2 it will become RS and here R1 and R2 both are 24 and it will become 48 so it will become 220/48 and after dividing you will get the second answer now in parallel third case whenever these two resistors are connected in parallel then net resistance will be 1/24 + 1/24 and it will become 2/24 that is 1/12 and reciprocal of 1/12 is 12 so net current will be 220/12 so in this way we can solve this problem that is the question number 13 now the question number 14 compare the power used in 2 ohm resistor in each of the following circuit in first circuit a 6 volt battery is connected in series with two resistor one is of 1 ohm and second one is of 2 ohm so here a 6 volt battery and this is 2 ohm resistor and this is 1 ohm resistor and we have to calculate the power in 2 ohm resistor as we know in series current remain will same so first of all we will derive the net current through 2 ohm resistor. First of all, we will calculate the net resistance, that is 2 and 1, it become 3 ohm. So net resistance in series is 3 ohm and V is 6 volt. So I must be equal to V by R, and R is here, net R is 3, so 6 by 3 become 2. So current flowing through each resistor will be 2 ampere. Now we have to calculate the power drop in 2 ohm resistor. As we know, P is equal to I square R, and I is 2 ohm, and value of R is also 2. Therefore, it will become 2 to the 4 and then 4 to the 8. So, power drop will be 8 watt. Now, in the second case, a 4 volt battery is given, which is connected to the 12 ohm and 2 ohm resistor. And in this case also, we have to calculate the power in 2 ohm resistor. Here, 4 volt battery connected to 12 and 2 ohm resistor. Since we know in parallel voltage will remain same, so 4 volt will drop here, 4 volt will be here, and we know P is also equal to V into I. V is 4 and I is 2, so 4 to the 8 watt. So in both cases, the power through resistor through the given circuits will be same, that is 8 watt for first case and 8 watt for the second case, and then their ratio will be 8 by 8, that is 1 by 1. So in this video lecture we are going to discuss up to here. Now we will do next question next time in the next video.